हेलो, आई एम प्रोफेसर कल्पेश पटेल, इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम द महात्मा गांधी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च सेंटर नवसारी। और सब्जेक्ट इज कंट्रोल सिस्टम थियोरी ऑफ द बी थर्ड ईयर फिफ्थ साइंस एंड सब्जेक्ट कोड इज 3130905। और सेकंड चैप्टर नेम इज टाइम रिस्पॉन्स एनालिसिस। दिस इज द फ्लो ऑफ कंटेंट्स from which in previous lecture we completed the third topic, application of initial value and final value theorem. So in this lecture we will conduct the fourth topic, design specification for the second order systems based on the time response. Now the derivation of unit step response of the second order systems. Now let us see the role of zeta in the response. Zeta, it is known as the damping ratio. Let's obtain the solution of response Ct to a unit step input Rs. So here input is unit step Rs, that means Rt equal to Ut. So it Laplace transform Rs equal to 1 by S. And we have the general equation for the second order systems, Cs by Rs equal to omega n square divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n square. Therefore Cs equal to omega n square divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n square into Rs. If we put the value of Rs equal to 1 by s in these equations, so the Cs equal to omega n square divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n square into Rs equal to 1 by s. Now consider the case 1, which is the underdamped system. Underdamped, that means the zeta vary from 0 to 1. So from these equations, Cs equal to omega n square divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega ns omega n square. So here we have Cs equal to omega n square divided by s in bracket s square plus 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n square. So by taking the LCM, we get this kind of equations, 1 by s minus s plus 2 zeta omega n plus divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n square. Now we convert this equation in this form, so which we have to add and subtract the value zeta square omega n square. This is subtracted and this is minus, so it becomes plus, so this will be added, so this term will cancel out. That means at this we add zeta square omega n square and subtract zeta square omega n square, so this term will cancel out. So if we make this equation in this form, so this s plus zeta omega n square equal to s square plus 2 zeta omega n plus zeta square omega n square. So this term is added in this equation, and this term s square plus 2 zeta omega n square plus omega n square zeta square. So this term is added in this form. So if we solve these equations, we get these equations. So here we added zeta square omega n square and subtracted zeta square omega n square. So we get here two terms. One is this and one is this. Now we know the damping frequency omega d equal to omega n under root 1 minus zeta square. If we take the square both sides, so we get omega d square equal to omega n square and 1 minus zeta square. That means omega n square minus omega n square and zeta square. So omega n square minus omega n square zeta square equal to omega d square. So if we put the value of this omega n square minus omega n square m zeta square equal to omega d. So we get this kind of equation, which is as it is, and this term equal to omega d square. Also here this term remains as it is, and this term equal to omega d square. So we get cs equal to 1 by s minus s plus zeta omega n divided by s plus zeta omega n whole square plus omega d square minus zeta omega n divided by s plus zeta omega n square plus omega d square. Omega d is called damping natural frequency and omega n is called undamped natural frequency. So from the Laplace transforms we know that this is standard Laplace of, suppose the term in this form s plus a divided by s plus a square by plus d square. So its Laplace transform become e raised to minus at cos dt. Suppose here is s, and if in numerator it is constant a, then it becomes sine. Suppose or here is this term, so it is cos omega t. So we apply this theorem to solve these equations. So we apply, here is s, so it become in cos terms, and here is constant, so it is in sine form. So if we apply the standard Laplace transform for these equations, we get this. So Laplace inverse of s plus zeta omega n divided by s plus zeta omega n square plus omega d square. So here a is zeta omega n and d equal to omega d square. So if we replace a with zeta omega n and d with omega d square, so we get the Laplace transform of this term in this form, e raised to minus at, so it is e raised to minus zeta omega n t, and cos dt equal to cos, here d equal to omega dt. Same for these terms, here a equal to zeta omega n and d equal to omega d, so e raised to minus at sin dt. So first we to make this bracket in single power, so if we multiplied by omega d and divide by omega d in of these equations, suppose we multiplied with omega d and divide by omega d, so this zeta omega n divide by omega d is the constant term. So this equation becomes omega d divided by s plus zeta omega n square plus omega d square. So now we apply this Laplace transform of, so here a equal to omega d, a equal to omega d plus here d equal to omega d square. So if we apply e raised to minus at sin dt, so here zeta omega n by omega d is constants, so e raised to minus at, a is minus zeta omega n t, and here d equal to the omega dt. So here a equal to zeta omega n, so e raised to minus zeta omega n t, and omega d equal to omega dt. All we know omega d equal to omega n 1 minus under root zeta square. So thus the term zeta omega n by omega d becomes zeta omega n divided by omega d. Now omega d equal to the omega n under root 1 minus zeta square. So omega d equal to omega n under root 1 minus zeta square. So this omega n and this omega n will cancel out, so the remaining term zeta divided by 1 minus zeta square. So this is the value of zeta omega n by omega d. So the value of this zeta omega n divided by omega d equal to zeta upon 1 minus under root 1 minus zeta square. Thus the total Laplace inverse of the equations, this 1 over s equal to 1 over 1, 1 over s equal to Laplace of 1 over s equal to 1, and the this is for second term and this is for the third term. So ct equal to 1 minus, if we take common, zeta raised to omega n t. So here we get cos omega t dt minus, here take minus common, so this minus and minus become plus. So zeta divided by under root 1 minus 1 plus zeta square sin omega t dt, this term is common. So ct equal to 1 minus, if we take LCM of 1 under root 1 plus zeta square, so if we take common outside the bracket, so we get the e raised to minus zeta omega t divided by 1 minus zeta square, but here in numerator no under this term, so we multiply this term with this term, so we get under root 1 minus zeta square omega cos omega dt plus zeta into sin omega dt, zeta into sin omega dt. Now consider the triangle which have this term is 90 degree, this is the angle alpha, this is zeta, and this is under root 1 minus zeta square. From this triangle, cos alpha equal to zeta divided by 1 and sin alpha equal to 1, under root 1 minus zeta square divided by 1, so we get cos alpha equal to zeta and sin alpha equal to under root 1 minus zeta square. So if we put the value of cos alpha and sin alpha in these equations, we get this ct equal to 1 minus this term as it is. So 1 minus zeta square equal to sin alpha, so here sin alpha cos omega dt as it is plus sin omega dt as it is, sin omega t dt, and zeta equal to cos alpha, zeta equal to cos alpha. So we get these equations. Now we have the general equation sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. So solution of this term equal to sin a plus b. So if we solve this equation, so it becomes sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. So here we have these equations, sin a sin alpha cos omega dt plus cos alpha sin omega dt. So if we compare these equations with these equations, so a equal to omega dt and b equal to alpha, so a equal to omega dt and b equal to alpha. The solution of this equation is sin a plus b. So here we get the solution of this equations equal to sin omega dt plus alpha, that means here a equal to omega dt and b equal to alpha. As all we know, sin divided by cos equal to 10, so sin alpha divided by cos alpha equal to 10 alpha. So tan alpha equal to sin alpha equal to under root 1 minus zeta square and cos alpha equal to zeta. So tan alpha equal to under root 1 minus zeta square divided by zeta. So alpha equal to tan inverse this. So alpha equal to tan inverse under root 1 minus zeta square divided by zeta. So if we put the value of alpha in this equation 5, so we get output response ct equal to 1 as it is, this term also as it is, and sin omega dt plus alpha equal to tan inverse under root 1 minus zeta square. So this is the equation of the output equation of the second order system for the unit step input. So equation 5 and 6 represents the solution of the underdamped system for the case, solution of the second order system for the value of zeta between 0 and 1, which is known as the underdamped systems. If you notice that the response contains sine term multiplied by the exponential decay term, so this is the sine term and this is the exponential decay term. So this output response is the multiplication of the sine term and the exponential decay term. The result will be sinusoidal decay. So if we get resultant of these two terms, we get the sinusoidal decay on exponential envelope. So the sine term, it is this sine term, and this is the exponential decay term. This is the sine term and this is the exponential decay term. If you multiply these two response, so we get the sinusoidal with decaying. This is the constant sine wave and this is exponential decay. Decaying, that means its value is decreasing as the time is increasing. So if you multiply these two equations, we get sinusoidal decaying. That decaying, that means as increase the time, the magnitude of the sine wave is decreasing. So this is the function of e raised to minus at exponential and product of sine omega t. So this is the sinusoidal decaying functions. From this equations, the CT is 1 minus product of exponential decay and sine term. So if we shift these equations above the magnitude 1, so we get this kind of equations. Response CT, which is the exponentially decay, 1 minus e raised to minus CT sine omega t. So this is the time response of the second order system for the unit step inputs. So it is for the value of zeta, which is vary from 0 to 1. Now the transient response time domain specifications of the second order systems for underdamped conditions. So the actual behavior of output of the any systems, which is this kind of. So this is the x axis indicate the time and y axis indicate the magnitude. If we consider the desired output equal to 1, so the output response vary according to the time for a particular time. So up to the TS, the time response is known as the settling time. So these settling times indicate the time required to become steady state of the system. So after the died of the transient response, the steady state time will start. So before become to steady state, the output is vary for a different time interval. So if you consider the time many kind of times. TR indicate the rise time, TP indicate the peak time, TD indicate the delay time. So the transient response is consist of rise time, peak time, delay time and settling times. So all the these times are come in the transient response, and after transient response is died out, steady state response will start. The steady state response is defined as the output reach as the plus or minus 2% of the desired outputs. So this is the steady state error, which is generally taken as the 2% of the desired output. Now some important specifications are as follow. First one is the delay time, which is denoted by TD. So it is the time required for a systems to response reach at the 50% of the final value in first attempts. That means the output response reach at the 50% of the desired output. Suppose desired output is 1, so 50% is 0.5. so the in first attempt the response reach at 50% of desired output up to this times, which is known as the delay time TD. So this is the output response reach at 50%. So this time is known as the delay time TD. Second term is rise time tr. So the time required for a response to rise from 10% to 90% of the final value for the damped systems and 0 to 100% for underdamped systems. So this is the underdamped systems. So when the response reach at 100%, so this is the output response reach at 100% at this time. So this time in known as the TR, rise time. Third one is a peak overshoot, MP. So this is the maximum overshoot, is the maximum peak value of the response curve measured from unity. It is therefore the largest error between the input and output during the transient period. So this peak overshoot is the magnitude, not in time. So as per the definitions, when the output response peak maximum at first times during the transient period, so from the desired output to the maximum output, this magnitude is known as the peak overshoot, which is denoted by the MP. Fourth one is a peak time TP. So it is time required for the response to reach the first peak. So when the system output response reach at the maximum peak, the time required for this, it is known as the TP, peak times. So this is the peak magnitude first time attempts. So this time is peak time TP. Fifth one is settling time TS. So it is the time required for response curve to reach the reach and stay within a specified percentage, usually 2% to 5% of the final value. That means at settling time, system becomes steady state. So if we consider the 2% error, so the suppose desired is the 1, so 2% is the 0.98 and 1.02. So when the output output response reach at this specified limit, so this time interval is known as the settling times. So this is the settling time TS. Now the derivation of performance indices. Now we have the equation of CT equal to 1 minus C raised to minus zeta omega nt divided by under root 1 minus zeta square into sine omega dt plus tan inverse under root 1 minus zeta square divided by zeta. So first we derive the equation of the delay time td. So td is the time taken to reach the 50% of the output. That means the magnitude of ct equal to half if you consider the 1 is the desired output. So 50%, that means half. So if we take put the value of ct equal to half and time t is the delay time td, so we if we put the value of ct equal to half, so 1 minus e raised to minus here t is replaced by td and also this t is replaced by td. The solution of these equations beyond the scope of this book, so it is very large. So if we solve these equations, we get the td, delay time td equal to 1 plus 0.7 zeta divided by omega n. So this delay time depend on two factors. One is damping factor zeta and the natural frequency of oscillation omega n. So this is the equation for delay time. So this time required to reach the 50 output response 50% at the desired outputs. Now the second term is the rise time tr. Now if we replace the t with tr and ct equal to 1, because the rise time tr is defined as the when time required to reach the output response ct as first time first attempt in desired output. So ct equal to 1 and tr is replaced by t is replaced by tr. So if you put the value of ct equal to 1 and t replaced by tr, so we get these equations. So this one and this one will cancel out, so remaining term is this. As e raised to minus zeta omega n tr is not equal to 0, this term is not equal to 0, so this term is 0. So if we consider this term equal to 0, sin omega d tr plus tan inverse under root 1 minus zeta squared by zeta equal to 0. That means now the sin 0 equal to 0, so this angle equal to 0. So if we take the value omega d tr plus tan inverse under root 1 minus zeta squared by zeta equal to 0, so we get the value of tr equal to minus tan inverse under root 1 minus zeta squared divided by zeta whole divided by omega d. So this is the value of rise time tr equal to this. Now consider this triangle, its angle beta, this is omega n, and this magnitude is omega n under root 1 minus zeta square, and this magnitude is zeta omega n. Now we consider the beta, so the tan beta equal to the this value divided by this. So this omega n, this omega n will cancel out. That means tan beta equal to under root 1 minus zeta square divided by zeta. So if we consider only beta, so beta equal to tan inverse under root 1 minus zeta square divided by zeta. So if you multiply both by omega n, so this omega n under root 1 minus zeta square equal to omega d. So beta equal to tan inverse omega d divided by zeta omega n. So if we put the value of beta equal to tan inverse omega d by zeta omega n, we get the rise time tr equal to minus this tan inverse equal to beta into omega. So if you put this value of beta in this equations, we get the rise time tr equal to minus beta divided by omega d. But now the beta in radians equal to pi minus beta, so it is rise time equal to pi minus beta in omega d. So this is time in second. Now we find the peak value. Now we find the time required to reach the system response at peak value. So this is indicated by tp. So we have the equation ct equal to this. So if we replace the value of tan inverse under root 1 minus zeta square divided by zeta with b, so we get this kind of equations. Now when the system reaches at its peak value, so at that time if we derivate these equations with respect to time, so its magnitude becomes 0. That means dc by dt at time tp equal to 0. So if you derivate these equations, we get dc divided by dt equal to derivation of 1 equal to 0 minus as it is. And here this is the derivation of the two product. That means first we consider the constant remains as it is. That means sin omega dt plus beta as it is, and derivation of this equal to e raised to something. That means e raised to as it is. That means e raised to minus zeta omega n t, e raised to minus zeta omega n t, against the derivation of these terms, minus zeta omega n t equal to minus zeta omega n, and as it is constant term, and t derivation of t equal to 1 against minus, but here minus, so it is minus minus plus. Now this term as it is, and take the derivative of this term. So this term as it is, and derivative of sine is cos. So sine omega dt plus beta equal to cos omega dt plus beta. Again the derivation of omega dt plus beta equal to omega d constants, and derivative of t equal to 1 plus b equal is the constant term, so derivation of constant term is 0. So we get this kind of equation. Also the under root 1 minus zeta square is constant, so remain as it is. But this is equal to 0. So if we put value this equal to 0, we get this. So if we move this term from right side of equal to sign to the left side of equal to sign, it become plus. So here we get plus, and this is the minus. So it is minus equal to 0. Now we take common these terms. If we take common these terms, remaining term will, this is also common. So this is the common term. So if we take common, so remaining term is zeta omega n sine omega dt plus beta. So zeta omega n sine omega dt tp plus beta minus omega d cos omega d tp plus beta minus omega d cos omega d tp plus beta equal to 0. This common term, if you move from left side of the equal to sign to the right side, so it is multiplied by the 0. So the resultant becomes 0. So we get these equations. Now as we all know, omega d equal to omega n under root 1 minus zeta square. So if we replace the value of omega d with respect with this omega n under root 1 minus zeta square, we get this kind of equations: zeta omega n sine omega d tp plus beta minus omega d replaced by omega n under root 1 minus zeta square equal to 0. Now we solve these equations. If we move this term from left side to the right side, it become plus. So this is become equal to, so this term equal to these terms. So if we move this term from left side to the right side, so it is divided by sine omega d tp plus beta divided by cos omega d tp plus beta and equal to sine divided by cos equal to 10. So this term both become 10, and remaining term omega n under root 1 minus zeta square divided by this zeta omega n, zeta omega n. So this omega n will cancel out. So remaining term is under root 1 minus zeta square divided by zeta. So we get 10 equal to this. Now beta equal to tan inverse under root 1 minus zeta square divided by zeta. Therefore tan beta equal to under root 1 minus zeta square divided by zeta. So this equal to tan beta. That means tan omega d tp plus beta equal to tan beta. Therefore tan omega d tp plus beta equal to tan beta. From the trigonometric identities, tan n pi plus theta equal to tan theta. So if we compare this equation with this, here tan n pi equal to omega d tp plus theta equal to beta. That means n pi plus beta equal to tan beta. Therefore this omega d tp equal to n pi. That means omega d tp equal to n pi. Therefore tp equal to n pi divided by omega d, where n is equal to 1, 2, 3 up to infinity. Then, so from this equation we can calculate the time for first peak response. So first peak occur at n equal to 1. So if you put the value of n equal to 1 in this equation, we get the tp equal to pi upon omega d, or omega d equal to omega n under root 1 minus zeta square. For n equal to 3, we get the first undershoot, and n equal to 3, we get second overshoot, and so on. So So for n equal to 1, we get this first overshoot. For n equal to 2, we get first undershoot. N equal to 3, we get second overshoot, and up to so on. Now we find the peak overshoot MP. This is the transient response of the second order systems under depth second order systems. So this magnitude is the known as the peak overshoot MP. So this point is CT maximum when T equal to TP. That's why this is the CT at T equal to TP, and this is the desired output. So if we subtract this desired one output from this peak value, we get the MP. So MP is defined as CT at T equal to TP minus 1. Now we have the equation of CT equal to 1 minus e raised to theta omega n TP divided by under root 1 minus theta square sine omega d TP plus beta. Now TP equal to pi upon omega d. That means TP into omega d equal to pi. So here we put omega d TP equal to pi. So therefore MP equal to CT, which is this 1 minus e raised to minus zeta and TP divided by under root 1 minus zeta square and sine omega d TP equal to pi plus beta and minus 1. So this minus and this minus will cancel out. So remaining term is this. Therefore MP equal to, now the sine pi plus beta equal to sine is the odd function. That means pi plus beta equal to minus sine beta. This minus sine beta and this minus sine beta become plus. So we get MP equal to this. Now consider this triangle. So the OM is the OM square plus OP square equal to MP square. So this relation gives the value of OM equal to omega n under root 1 minus zeta square. Therefore sine beta equal to omega n under root minus zeta 1 minus zeta square divided by sine beta equal to OM divided by MP. So OM equal to this divided by MP equal to omega n. So this omega n will cancel out. So sine beta equal to under root 1 minus zeta square. So if we put the value of sine beta in this equation, we get the MP equal to e raised to minus zeta omega n TP divided by under root 1 minus zeta square, and sine beta equal to also under root 1 minus zeta square. So this term will cancel out, and we get the MP equal to e raised to minus zeta omega n TP. Also TP is equal to pi upon omega d. Also omega d equal to omega n under root 1 minus zeta square. So if we put this value in these equations, we get the MP equal to e raised to minus zeta omega d equal to omega n under root 1 minus zeta square. So this omega and this omega will cancel out. The remaining term is pi upon under root 1 minus zeta square. Normally MP is expressed in percentage. Therefore MP percentage equal to this term multiplied by 100. Now we calculate the settling time TS. Generally settling time TS is defined as the 2% error in output response. So as in previous lecture we studied at time constant 4T, the output response reach at the 2% 98% of the desired output. So we can consider the settling time as TS as the 4T. Also the T equal to 1 by zeta omega n. So if you put the value of T 1 by zeta omega n in this equation, we get the settling time TS equal to 4 divided by zeta omega n. Now we solve the control systems examples based on this theory. So here one example is given. The control system having unity feedback has GS equal to 20 divided by s, 1 plus 4s and 1 plus s. So determine first different static error coefficients, and second one is a steady state error if input RT equal to 2 plus 4t plus t square by 2, and how to reduce the steady state error. So first we find the different static error coefficients, which is the Kp, Kv and Ka. Kp is the position error constants, Kv equal to velocity error constants, and Ka equal to acceleration error constants. So all the equations of Kp, Kv and Kv are derived in previous lecture. So Kp equal to limit s tends to 0 Gs Hs. Here Gs Hs equal to 10 to s, 1 plus 4s and 1 plus s. So if you put the value of s equal to 0 in these equations, so numerator, denominator become the 0. So the this term become infinity. And Kv is defined as limit s tends to 0 as Gs Hs. So s Gs Hs equal to 10t divided by s, 1 plus 4s, 1 plus s. So this s and this cell will cancel out. So if you put the value of s equal to 0 in remaining term, we get 1 plus 0 and 1 plus 0. So this is 20 by 1. So we get Kv equal to 20. And third one is a Ka, acceleration error constants. It is defined as limit s tends to 0 s square Gs Hs. So if you put the value of Gs Hs equal to 20 divided by s, 1 plus 4s, 1 plus s. So 1 L s will cancel out. So if you put the value of s equal to 0, so here in numerator s, 1 s is remain. So if you put the value of 0, the numerator becomes 0. So the whole term become 0. So for this example, Kp equal to infinity, Kv equal to 20 and Ka equal to 0. Now we solve the second terms to reduce the steady state error. So we have RT, input is given in these forms. So if we convert this time domain to the Laplace transform, so RS equal to 2 as it is and 1 is 1 by s plus 4t, so 1 over s square plus t square by 2. So here 1 by 2 as it is, t square by 2, that means 2 factorial divided by t raised s raised to n plus 1. So here n equal to 2, so the n factorial is equal to 2 factorial divided by s raised to 2 plus 1, so it is 1 by s cube, and these 2 and numerator 2 will cancel out. Now the steady state error ESS is defined as the limit s tends to 0 s ES. So if you put the value of s ES, ES is defined as RS divided by 1 plus GSHS, which is already derived in previous lectures. So we put the value of GSHS equal to 20 divided by s, 1 plus 4s, 1 plus s. So if we solve these equations, we get these kinds of equations: RS, 1 plus 4s, 1 plus s and s square divided by 1, this means 20 plus this term s, 1 plus 4s and 1 plus s. Now we put the value of RS. So RS equal to 2 by s, 4 by s square and 1 by s cube. Here this 1 plus 4s, 1 plus s, 1 plus 4s, 1 plus s will cancel out and 1 s will also cancel out. So remaining term is, if we also we multiply this s with these equations, we get 2 plus 4 by s plus 1 by s square, and denominator this is the 1 plus 20. So we get this equation. So if we put the s equal to 0 in these equations, we get the s equal to 0, that means 4 by 0 is also infinity, 1 by 0 is also infinity. So the numerator is infinity, so we get the steady state error infinity. Now we solve the another examples based on the time response analysis of the second order systems. So here transfer function Cs by Rs is given by 1 by s square plus s plus 1. So find out the time domain specifications. The time domain specification, that means rise time, delay time, peak time and settling time. So So first we compare the denominator with the standard equation of the second order system, which is the s square plus 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n square. So if we compare these equations with these equations, we get the here s square and the coefficient of s is equal to 1, so that means these 2 zeta omega ns equal to 1, also 1 equal to omega n square, that therefore omega n square equal to 1, so we get omega n equal to 1, and these coefficients s is equal to 1, so here we get 1. If we put the value of omega n from this equation is 1, we get the value of zeta, which is zeta equal to 1 divided by 2, so zeta equal to 0.5. as we know, omega d equal to omega n under root 1 minus zeta square. So if we put the value of omega n and zeta, we get omega d damping frequency is equal to 0.866 radian per second. So natural frequency omega n equal to 1, damping factor zeta equal to 0.5, and first we find the rise time tr equal to pi minus beta upon omega d. So here beta equal to tan inverse under root 1 minus zeta square divided by zeta. If we put the value of zeta equal to 0.5 in this equation, we get the value of beta. So tr equal to pi minus beta equal to 1.047 divided by omega d equal to 0.866. so this will give the time rise time tr. Now the delay time td is defined as the 1 plus 0.7 zeta divided by omega d. So if we put all the value of zeta and omega d, we get this equation: 1 plus 0.7 zeta equal to 0.5 divided by omega d equal to 0.866. this gives the magnitude 1.558 seconds. So delay time td equal to 1.558 seconds. Now the we find the peak time tp, which is defined as the pi upon omega d. Pi equal to 3.14 divided by omega d equal to 0.866. so we get tp equal to 0.3627 seconds. Now we find the percentage of peak overshoot, which is defined as 100 into e raised to pi minus zeta divided by under root 1 minus zeta square. So pi zeta equal to 0.5, under root 1 minus zeta square to 0.5 square, which give the magnitude of MP in percentage, which is equal to 16.30%. Now settling time TS is 4 by zeta omega n, 4 by zeta equal to 0.4 and omega n equal to 1, so we get the 8 seconds. So system take the time 8 seconds to become steady states. Now the GTU question. First one, the closed loop transfer functions given second order system is given by GS equal to 100 divided by S square plus 10S plus 100. Determine the damping ratio, natural frequency, delay time, rise time, settling time and peak times. This question may be asked in your GTU examination for a 7 marks. So you have to first write all the equations of these terms and calculate the values. Second one is the define rise time, peak time and overshoot and settling time. So in this equation you have to just define these terms. So maybe ask in your GTU examination for 3 marks. Third one is for a second order system with unity feedback. Unity feedback, that means HS equal to 1. The transfer function GS is 20 by S, S plus 8. To find the frequency domain specification, that means this term you have to calculate it. But this is the GS and the unity feedback, that means your transfer function is 1 plus GS HS, in which we have to put GS equal to this and HS equal to 1. So the characteristic equation is 1 plus GS HS, compare with the standard form of the second order systems, S square plus 2 zeta omega n and omega n square, and find all the terms. So in previous in next lecture we will conduct the concept of stability using RS stability criteria. So all these terms all these topics, 4, are completed. Thank you.